Okay, thank you everyone to stay back here until now. Okay, I'm Cheah, Microsoft MVP, but I'm not working in Microsoft. You will frequently see me in Microsoft event. This is my Twitter, my email, and my YouTube channel. But you don't ask me how to get the money from YouTube channel. The one you must explore by yourself, because I also not earn anything. Okay, for the last 3 years, everyone is talk about the DevOps. But in the DevOps side, do you know about security? No, right? Because every time I get my developer team, they always tell me my lecturer not teach. Then we no need to learn. It is very wrong concept from if you future you want to as a developer. Okay, in a challenge of DevOps, the developer most of the time is not like the changing requirement of the client requirement, because everyone when it's changed, it will extend the timeline. Okay, and also the more development technology are available, because every time you, for example, like you write a C# application, maybe you want to integrate with the Node.js or everything like JavaScript also. They also affect each other of affect your colleague that are same team with you for development. Okay, therefore also has wide-ranging operational responsibility, because from the Harris talk about the from a requirement until the end of the development, every state, for example, like stakeholder also need to involve your developer, your task, your project manager also involved, because every time you only think you should come in at the end of the testing phase, because a lot of project manager is coming at the last stage of the development, it's a testing phase, but they only found out all the thing is not suitable to the client requirement. And also during the testing phase, the client always asks that is that your application secure or not? Because they give the rest. They trust you. Your development team always got security and got do the security assessment. From my experience, got one project is more on library. Every time after the client test the application, then come back to us. They always tell us the time you tell us our application is very secure. Why still have this vulnerability? Then after that, we always go back to a developer. You say you secure, right? But actually not secure. Just like some case happened during last year in Singapore. But I think they take some step to recover the data leak from the database. Okay, addressing the DevOps security challenge, this is more important. Because from not only you need to know the security thing, even you are project manager, you also need to understand the security. But how frequent the security change, you need to find out a lot of things from the news. For example, like OSOC, always list now the top 10 security vulnerability like SQL, SQL injection and cross-site scripting. It's the most common I go through 5 years that always list at the top of the security vulnerability. Okay, today I will share with you about the Azure Secure DevOps Kit. Here you see the Azure word, right? The Azure, but the Azure is charging, but today for your development, it's not charging yet. It can implement in the .NET C#. Okay, here at the beginning, I show you, I told you about the who should involve. Here, the Azure Security Dev Secure DevOps Kit. Each of the stakeholder is also involved, because not only today everyone is talking about security and also full stack. The full stack is supposedly is go through the every person in the team. Not only the tester problem. Okay, and here inside the Azure Secure DevOps Kit, it provides you the security in the subscription, the debug, the spot check with the security, with the script, inside a continue DevOps, then deploy and release the application, then assurance, then and also the single security dashboard across the DevOps stack, and also make data-driven improvement to the security. Okay, let's go for step by step. The first one, provision security in subscription. A secure cloud subscription provides a core foundation upon which subsequent development and deployment activity can be conducted. An engineering team should have the capability to deploy to configure security in the subscription, including elements such as alert, the arm policy, and also the resources log. Because at this stage, everyone can access to the data, but no access to your code, your source code, but how you control. Yeah, every time you can revert back, but you will affect other developer also. You need to log out some resources that not allow some people to access to the data. For example, like your colleague, maybe before that you all sign the data with sign the contract with the client that say that you will not leak the data to the public. But you can't ensure this one happen in your development team. Okay, for second one, security intelligence sense. Because a lot of developers currently does not know about how to implement the security inside your coding. Then with the security intelligence sense, you are then it will automatically suggest you about the source code syntax to you. And the third one, the test automation, because from the test automation is a core tenet of DevOps. We emphasize this by providing the capability by running SVTs as part of the CI and CD pipeline. Okay, to ensure that the target subscription used to deploy to a cloud application and the Azure resources the application is built upon all set up in a secure manner. Okay, for the continuous assurance roadmap. In the constantly changing of DevOps environment, it is important to move away from the mindset of security within a milestone. This is made possible through capability that enable continuous assurance using a combination of automation roadmap schedule. Because every time I know a lot of people when need to test, they always ask the developer to test. Maybe sometimes your tester will be careless, then you will miss up some of the automation. With the secure DevOps kit, it will help you automate when to run the testing. Okay, visibility of OMS solution for alerting and monitoring. Single security dashboard across the DevOps stack. Because every time when after you implement the Azure Secure DevOps Kit, after that you testing, you publish the application to the cloud is that is that you don't need to carry. Because in the one project, yeah, they will have an extra 3 months of the for maintenance. That means that you will still need to maintain the application for security purpose. Because every when some attack, DDoS attack or SQL injection attack or cross-site scripting, you also will get the alert from the security DevOps security monitoring. Okay, here you will see this in the Microsoft Operation Management Suite. Okay, the last one, to make the data-driven improvement for the security, cloud-rich government. Underlying all the activity in the kit is a telemetry framework that generates events and capture the user's adoption. For example, like the call, every time you get attacked, Microsoft will collect the data, which hacker from which country, what they do. Then after that, you also can, if they changing your data, then you can recover back from the data from the previous data. Okay, I will show you the demo. Okay, anyone using the Visual Studio? Okay, a few, okay. Okay, just now, I think, hello, Harry share about some tools. I think some of that is paying, and CK also raised about a .NET. Because I know commonly a lot of company is using the Vira code. Okay. I can. Okay. Okay. I know this one is more commonly used by other company during their software development. The company at nearby here only, but today I will show you another one. Okay, here you search for security, but you only need to install this one, Security Intelligence Sense, at the preview, stay in preview state, because they always get, always collect the data and update from time to time. Other than that, you can do the security code scan, but it without suggestions of the how to implement it, but you can try it. Okay, here I show Giga. Okay, here you will see that after I install the Security Intelligence Sense, you will see that the red line, that means that got some suggestions for you. Then you just click and press the Security Intelligence Sense CS and CA. Then it will suggest you about the source code that using the ING. That one I do it before that for this one. They will suggest you a different, for example, ING, MD5 and H8A. Okay, I just finish. Okay, it suggests you an ING crypto service provider. Other than that, it's also also for the access permission, because who can read the data and list the data and also then I think this one. Okay, at the same time it's also collect your behavior like from how the user enter the data, also involve the Active Directory from the client. Okay, other than that, the most common is the XML document because everyone is save the temporary data as XML for the development. For the reference, you can go for this URL to understand more about the Azure Secure DevOps Kit, because this one also used by the software engineer in the Microsoft. Then you will get the latest update from the Intelligent Secure DevOps Kit. Okay, that's all for my session. Thank you. Any question?
Yeah.
No? Okay. If you want to know more, next week we got one event. It's Azure DevOps Community Launch. We will share more about the DevOps. Okay, thank you.